Hello children, welcome to our 8th class, 8th session class. Children, we are in the last topic, that is lithosphere. In the last class, we learned what is lithosphere. As per the topic, we learned the division of our earth like crust, core and mantle. And thereafter, we learned what are the subdivision in the crust, mantle as well as the core. And then we learned what are the forces of our earth crust. It means that crust is the upper part of the earth, we know. And which are the forces which bring changes upon the earth? Then we referred internal forces. Internal forces in the sense the changes which took place inside the earth and which resulted the changes outside the earth. I'll repeat once again. Internal forces refer to a changes which took place inside the earth and which resulted changes upon or on the earth. There we referred volcanoes and earthquake, and external forces which refer as a weathering as well as a denudation. Then we completed what is a volcano, types of a volcano, meaning of a volcano, active volcano, example for active volcanoes, and second type dormant volcano, and the example for the dormant volcanoes are, and the third one is extinct volcano. You know, I hope that you know the meaning and difference between these different types of volcanoes, children. Then move on to the material which come out of the volcanoes are solid, liquid and gases. Then in the entire world, the distribution of a volcano, the places where we openly get to see the volcanoes, then earthquake, the meaning of an earthquake, which is a series of a shock or a tremor due to the sudden movement of a crustal rock, that is the earthquake. And then we divide it as a seismic focus or hypocenter. I told you to remember this word, seismic focus and hypocenter. And what is the epic center? And what is the seismology there you refer? There the scientific study of the earth quake is called as a seismology. Then the instrument which study the velocity of the earthquake, which refer to seismology. And due to the shake or the clash between plate A and plate B, it means that in the end of the crust and the beginning of a mantle, which consisted of a crystal rock, which we divide as a plate A and plate B, and there are many such rock, due to the clash or the movement of those rock which bring the earthquake upon the earth. The movement inside the earth or interior of the earth which changes took place, which is the interior of the earth, interior of the earth which bring the changes upon the earth, that refer to earthquake. And second reason is causes for the earthquake is that while getting the earthquake means the gases or the material which come out of the or which come interior of the earth which shake the plate or which disturb the structure of the crust as well as the mantle, which also cause the earthquake upon the earth. So we give the reason for the earthquake is that one is that the clashes or the shake between the plate, second one is volcanic eruption, and the third reason we like to give for man-made factor. We know that mining, huge construction of a huge dam, and the digging of a mining, all this cause as a man-made factor which also responsible for the earthquake. Now there we referred earthquake referred as a primary wave. Then now in the external forces we referred to weathering. What is the external forces? External forces means, as name itself suggests, that the forces which are outside the earth or the in the atmosphere, the atmospheric forces such as wind, air, all this consider, remember, all this consider as a external forces which bring changes upon the surface of the earth. Clear children? External forces as referred to natural forces which bring changes upon the earth. They may be divided as a weathering. What is a weathering? Weathering is a natural process of wearing away or breaking down of a gradual disintegration of a rock by the agent like temperature, rainfall, wind, etc., which presented in the atmosphere. See, as I told, external forces refer to forces, natural forces, which are presented in the nature and which support the disintegration of a rock. Here you can see a breakdown of a rock. See, this breakdown is due to the natural forces. So that was called it as a weathering, because children, I hope you remember that while referring to types of a rock, we referred primary rock, secondary rock, and the metamorphic rock, right? The primary rock, which is available naturally on the in the interior part of the earth, right? Primary earth, which is available on, sorry, which is available in the interior of the earth, and the sedimentary rock, we refer it as a alteration of a primary rock, whereas metamorphic rock is again the alteration of a primary as well as a secondary rock. There you have to observe the alteration of a primary as well as a secondary rock. These alteration is done by the natural forces. Children, are you getting? These alteration is going to done by the natural forces, not by any human forces, by the natural forces. That is referred as a weathering. Here weathering also referred as a same. See, weathering is a natural process of a wearing away or breaking down or gradual disintegration of a rock. What do you mean by gradual disintegration? Which means breakdown of a rock. Is it clear, children? Disintegration of a rock by the agent like temperature. You agree that temperature is a force of a natural forces. Then the rainfall, wind, which are presented in the atmosphere. Due to these forces, a natural weathering will take place. Depending upon that, we classify as a mechanical weathering, chemical weathering, and biological weathering. Though the weathering is depend upon the biological forces or the natural forces, on the basis of that, still we subdivide it into three types. These are mechanical weathering, chemical weathering, and biological weathering. Okay, what is mechanical weathering? In the first part of the weathering, children, we are doing mechanical weathering. What is a mechanical weathering? Mechanical weathering or physical weathering is a process when the rock is broke and disintegrated without any physical alteration. So mechanical weathering is also referred as a physical weathering. Is it clear, children? Mechanical weathering is also referred as a physical weathering, because while disintegration of a rock, see, a breakdown of a rock, you can see here, without any natural forces or without any chemical forces, there is no chemical reaction. Without the chemical reaction, a rock will break into pieces. See, you may observe here, you may not get to see any kind of a what? Chemical reaction. What do you mean by chemical reaction? Chemical reaction is mean one thing or one mineral with which dissolve with another chemical thing. Is it clear, children? What is chemical weathering? Or chemical means one mineral which dissolve with another chemical. That is a chemical reaction, you can say. Here in mechanical weathering, we can say that there is no chemical reaction in disintegration of a rock. I'll repeat once again, in physical or mechanical weathering, there is no chemical interference, or there is no chemical disintegration. The stone will disintegrate it physically. It means that due to the physical reason, a rock will break into two pieces or many pieces. That was called as a mechanical weathering. See, disintegrated without any chemical alteration. While writing mechanical weathering, children, you have to remember that the disintegration of a rock without any chemical alteration. Then what is a chemical alteration? See, so that these agent of a mechanical weathering are temperature, wind and frost, etc. So we can give reason for mechanical weathering is, one is temperature. Due to the temperature, a rock may break, or wind, or frost, or because of so much of a cold also, a rock may disintegrate. There we can say there is a no chemical reaction. Then what is a chemical reaction? What is a chemical reaction? Then second type of a weathering we refer, chemical weathering is mainly brought by the action of a substance dissolved in the water. So action of a substance dissolved in the water, what do you mean by that? It means that the rock, which already consists of a mineral, is it clear? The rock which already consists of a mineral, and that mineral substance which dissolved in the rainwater, is it clear? Because we referred, while referring the metamorphic rock, clear? Metamorphic rock, a one type of a rock will turn into another type. Right, children? I hope you remember. So that substance which already exists in a rock, that dissolved in the rainwater, then the action will take place. That's why we told weathering due to the natural forces, rainwater, temperature, these are the natural forces which bring the changes in the existing water. Here the rock is already consisted of a mineral substance, that mineral substance which dissolved or which dilute in the rainwater, that we totally together called it as a chemical weathering. Here this type of a weathering resulted in the changing the composition of the mineral present in the rock. So already it presents something mineral along with it, then after diluting or after dissolving in the rainwater, it will become something else. So changing the composition of the mineral presented in the rock. There are four types of a chemical weathering, like oxidation, carbonation, hydration and solution. In that, what is the oxidation? Oxidation says that in the stone, the oxygen present dissolved, the oxygen which present in the rock, which dissolved in the rainwater, and it will become rain iron or from the oxide. It means that, see, already oxygen which presented in the rock, after dissolving with the rainwater, the iron content which is available in the rainwater, which will become oxide. Clear? The iron which contained, which present in the rock, which will become oxide, that is a oxidation, because we know that the water consists of a oxygen, right? That oxygen will become oxide. Then second one is carbonation. What is the carbonation? Carbonation means the calcium carbonate which present in the rock. I'll repeat, the calcium carbonate which present in the rock, which will become calcium bicarbonate. Carbonation means calcium carbonate which present in the rock, which will become, after diluting in the rainwater, which will become calcium bicarbonate. Correct? Then hydration. What is the hydration? Hydration means the mineral like crystalline which presented in the rock, which will become powdery mass. You may have seen some of the rock will consist of a powder. Powder means like nice powder, like a material which we can observe in few of the rock. That is because of the crystalline which presented in a rock after dissolving in the rainwater, which will become powdery mass. Powdery mass is because of it already dissolved in the rainwater. After getting into a sunlight, it will dry up and it will become like a powder. Clear? That is a powdery mass. That we will call it as a hydration. So, and what is the solution? Solution means, we know, dissolving in the water. After few mineral dissolving in the rainwater, it will present the few another mineral upon the earth. which will increase or which may decrease the fertility of the land. That is what your textbook says. Solution means when the rainwater fall on the surface of the land, rainwater dissolve the soluble mineral presented in the rock. In the sense that, see, solution means the mineral which was presented in the rock, which will be soluble. Soluble in the sense swallowing. It will be done by the rock. Done by the rainwater. So what we have learned here, children? Chemical weathering. It means that the things or the mineral which presented in the rock, that will dissolve with the rainwater and it will turn into something other mineral. They we referred as the oxidation. Oxidation we referred the iron which is there in the rock, which will become oxide in the oxidation. Carbonation, the rock which consists of the calcium carbonate, after dissolving in the rainwater it will become calcium, it will become calcium bicarbonate. Then the hydration, where crystalline mineral which will present it as a powdery mass. And the solution refer to whatever mineral which was there on the land mass or the surface, not referring as a rock. Solution refer to the mineral which was contained on the surface of the land, that was swallowed by the rainwater. That was called as a solution. So we referred as a chemical weathering. We referred mechanical weathering, physical weathering. Mechanical weathering is also referred as a physical weathering and the chemical weathering. And third one is biological weathering. What is a biological weathering? Biological weathering is nothing but the name itself says that the disintegration of a rock which take place other than natural resources. Because we usually refer that in the external forces, the alteration or changes is took place because of the external forces which is presented in the atmosphere. There we refer chemical as well as a mechanical weathering. Another one is biological weathering. Biological weathering refer bio. Bio in the sense living organism. The disintegration will take place due to the living organism. What are the living organism, children? It may human being, animal or the plants. Clear? Because biological disintegration of a rock refer to the disintegration of a rock take place due to the living organism. There we refer to living organism are human being, animals and plants. How these three factors will responsible for disintegration of a rock? Let's take first one is animal plants. In the plants, growth and expansion of a root. While referring, and this one, plant is also called, referred it as a living organism, right? Why? When the root are deep rooted, because of the deep root of a plant, also few of the rock will disintegrate or it will break down. You may observe it, right? When the roots are take place deeply inside the earth, because of that rooting process, a rock will break down. You may observe. When you go to any hill station or any rock, there you may observe there is no clue of a soil, but still on that place, on that spot, a plant will grow. How? Because of the disintegration of a rock. Where a rock will break down, and in that break the root will grow up and the mineral will be dissolved or will be consumed by these roots. Due to that the plant will grow. So in the biological weathering we refer it, children, plant is also one of the reason for a biological weathering. Then what about animals? Animals, you know, burrowing. The rabbit will live in a burrow. Where? Because of the burrowing of animal, earthworms which will make a hole in the rock, because that is its living place. Because to live in that, it has to make a hole, the earthworms. Then the burrowing of animals like rabbits, rat, which will make a hole in the rock, that will also consider as a one of the reason in a biological weathering, right? One is plant, another one is animal. Then the third one is human being. Obviously, we have the reason for the exploitation of a natural things. That is how human being, that is mining, quarrying, then the construction work, because of the construction mill, we will take a, we will use a dynamo as and we will break the huge rock. We will go excessive use of a mineral resources. Because of these reason also, we break the natural resources. Children, here you observe that while the animal, then the plants and the chemical and the mechanical weathering, it will take several years to disintegrate or to break the rock. Do you agree? Yes, because you take mechanical weathering, where will be we can find out breakdown of a rock, and the chemical weathering in the sense, because the mineral which has to dissolve in the water, rain water. If you take a sugar, if you put it in a one glass of a water, it at least it will take 5 minutes to dilute, right? It need a 5 minutes to dilute, whereas the mineral which was presented in the rock, it needs several years to dilute. After taking a several year only it will dilute, then the disintegration of the rock will take place. Whereas these man-made factor like mining, then construction of a dam, it doesn't take several years. It take 3 months, more than 1 year, the entire work will be finished. So we can see that our human being contribution is more in disintegration of a rock. Clear, children? Then the next one is denudation. In the external forces, one is weathering. Clear? Then the another one is denudation. What do you mean by denudation? Denudation means the agent of a denudation like river, glacier, underwater, sea waves, all this considered as which bring the changes upon the surface. Means action or changing on the landscape. Because you take a river, when the river flows on the landmass, it will carry the mineral which was available on the earth. So denudation means action of a changing landscape or changing the surface of the earth by the various natural agent such as river, glacier, underwater, wind, sea waves, etc. This will called as a denudation, means which do the erosion, soil erosion, which carry the mineral available on the land, which will take along with that and which make the land as a burden land. So in that first we will refer it as a river. River is a main sources of a denudation. What is a river? River is a source of a water, right? River flowing from the source to mouth means how the river was made, anybody know? No, because according to us, river means a rainwater which fall upon the landmass and which will flow. After that flow, flowing water will join to the river. Correct? So that we can say as a river. Do you agree, children? The collection of rainwater or the rainwater which flow upon the surface of the land and it will join to the river, that will call it as a river. Here we can use few of the technical words like course. What is a course? The path of a river flow. Is it clear, children? What do you mean by course? Course means, see, this is a path where the rainwater falls, the way it will flow to join the river, that is called it as a course. Clear? See, this path is called it as a course. And what is a source? Source is the place where river takes birth. Source in the sense, the origin point of the river is called it as a course. Sorry, source. Course is the path of a river flow is called it as a course. Then what is a mouth? The point where river meets sea or ocean. What do you mean by mouth? Mouth is the point where merge of a river as well as a sea or a ocean. The name mouth means the joining part of a river as well as a ocean. Then what are the tributaries? Tributary is the feeder or the small stream that supply water to river along with its course. Tributary means water has to be filled in the river. How it will be filled? It can be done by with the help of a tributaries. These are the natural forces, children. Then what is the confluence? Confluence refer to the point where the tributaries join the main river. See, these all the terms you all know, you are observed, but you don't know the technical terms. Suppose you take the course. Course means you observed when the rain water has been flowing. You don't know what it has to be termed, right, children? Recently you observed so much of flood in Udupi, right? That flow of the river or the path which will take place to join the river, that we refer it as a course. And source means the origin point of a river we consider as a source. Then the mouth is the point where river meets the sea as well as the ocean. Then the tributary means when rainwater is not available, what is the sources to fill the river, right? All the time rain is not possible, but we have not seen river is empty, right? So because of the tributaries, like the tributaries are feeder which feed the river always. These are the small streams supply of water along with the course, and the confluence is the point where tributaries join the main river. So mouth is river and ocean joining point. Mouth is joining point of a river as well as a ocean or a sea. Confluence is joining part of a tributaries as well as a river. So be aware and be used with these words. And what the river does, river makes a denudation in three stages. What do you mean by denudation? Now denudation means carrying the mineral which was presented in the land, and by flowing the water will carry the mineral which was presented in the land, right, children? That is a denudation. Denudation means the mineral which was present on the landmass, it was carried by the course. Course means a flowing of a water, right? So here river makes a denudation in three stages because the course of river is divided into three stages. They are flowing, and directly it is not going to join the river. While flowing also, it will follow the three steps. It will join in a three way, that is upper course, middle course and lower course. Upper course means while river directly go and join, the velocity is a vertical shape, children, right? And the speed of the water is also very speed, like a force. So it will take a vertical, vertical shape in the sense V shape, flowing in a vertical shape. So see, straight vertical line, that is the upper course. Middle course, little flow of the water is little less. And the lower course is settle down of a water. See, upper course, here while the river will flow from top, vertical, like Angel Falls, then Niagara Falls, Joe Falls can be example. Then in the middle course, the river enters the plain in this stage. The main work of river in this stage is to transportation of the little deposit. Because in the first course only, the mineral which was available, it will be shifted to river. Whereas in the second middle course, remaining deposit will be put into the taken by the river or the water. Then the third one is, like here middle course, we can give the example for alluvial fans. Alluvial fans is known for the rich deposit of a minerals which was presented in a rock. Meanders, which are the example where river is took in the second shape. Then the third one is lower course. In this state, the slope of the river course is very minimum, so that river flows slowly. Means, see, it is like an imagination, children. First, the fall will fall down, water will be fall down. After that, in the middle stage, river flowing. Then the third stage where water is settled down, like a river, flowing river. That is the lower case. See, in this stage, the slope of the river course is very much minimum, means very less, only flowing, no falling from the up or the top. Deposition is main work of the river here, like flood, plains, natural leaves, etc. Example for the lower course of the water is floodplains, natural lakes, Oxbow Lake, Barbed Coast, Delta or Corn Ear. See, this is the example. Upper course means where water falling from the top. Middle course means this, where it is be the river which is captured from the top, it will flow in the middle. I repeat once again. See, the water which fall from the top, it will be captured in the this region. Then the remaining is lower course. The remaining water which will comes here and it will flow. This is actually, children, imagination is that this is a fall. Imagine that this is a fall which will fall here. So here velocity or the speed of the water is very high, so that electricity we can generate because of the speed. And here the water which fall here and here the velocity is little bit less when compared to here. So here we can see the deposit or the mineral which is carried from here, that will be settled down here. So this region is very fertile, and this is lower course is exactly the river which we can see in the depth of the river, where the flow of the water is still stagnant. There is a no flow of a water. This is up to a denudation because of that. The remaining part is we will continue in the next class, children, till then you read whatever is done. Take care.